don't miss any content. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
CHAN 2020 group stage is over. A total of 24 matches were played, culminating in 46 goals being scored. We now know our quarter finalists. Today we're going to review the tournament so far and my predictions for the quarterfinal stage going into semi-finals and eventually the finals. Welcome back to the channel. Subscribe if you haven't and click on the notification bell to get more updates. So the CHAN tournament, which was supposed to be held in April, but because of COVID and other issues, it was postponed to January 2021. Cameroon have been great hosts, bar certain instances where there was no light in one of the games at the stadium and it was actually brought back immediately. Everything has gone according to plan. There have not been that many hiccups in this tournament. The tournament kicked off on Saturday the 16th of January with an amazing display of African and Cameroonian culture in that opening ceremony. Cameroon took to center stage and played their first game. It wasn't a convincing display, but they got the 3 points that they needed. In fact, in the opening stages of the competition, goals were far and few between. Before eventually getting to the latter groups, the goals started flowing. For me, I have to say the surprise package were Rwanda. They qualified from the group stages into the next stage. Togo had started the brightest in that group, Group C. But Rwanda, with that late onslaught, late determination in that game versus Togo, which they won 3-2 to take them through. The host Cameroon have not been convincing so far, but they got the job done. They got their goalless draw in that final game versus Burkina Faso, who were eventually in knockouts. They drew 1-1 with Mali and got that 1-0 win in the opening game with Zimbabwe, and they have gotten the job done, but they will need to up their game as they get into the next stage, which is the quarterfinals. They will be facing DR Congo, who have been a revelation also in this game, but they have won this tournament before and there are no newcomers to this tournament. DR Congo will be facing the host Cameroon, and that fixture is sure to be another scintillating one. Mali, I have to say, were great. They topped their group in Group A, getting 7 points, winning 2 games and drawing 1. And for their reward, they'll be facing Congo from Group B. Great matchup there, and I'm looking really forward to it. Morocco, who are the reigning champions of this tournament, they won it in 2018, and basically, essentially, the same team that won that tournament, but with a different coach. He hasn't or wasn't the best of start for Morocco. They got their 1-0 victory versus Togo, but it was under some controversial circumstances, a penalty that they shouldn't have been given or awarded, a penalty that they should have conceded. So much controversy behind that 1-0 win versus Togo, but they won and the controversial decisions went their way, winning that game 1-0. In their next game versus Rwanda, which was quite a shocker, they failed to find the back of the net and they drew 0-0 with Rwanda. I think that was when we should have spotted Rwanda as a team that we should be really careful about. Rwanda drew 0-0 with the reigning champions, that is Morocco, and it was something that meant that the Moroccans needed to sit up. A draw would have been enough for them to qualify to the next stage, but what a statement they made in their final game versus Uganda. Uganda also needed a win to go through. It was open. I have to say, it was open at least until the final game days. Only 2 teams had been eliminated after match day 2, and those 2 teams were Namibia and Zimbabwe, and it was really competitive. This tournament has been competitive so far, and Morocco, they stood up as champions always do and thrashed Uganda 5-2. It was as if the floodgates for the goals had opened and they were just scoring left, right, center. That is the highest scoring game in the tournament so far. 5-2 in the group stages. Little did we know there was more drama in their final game when Rwanda took on Togo. A draw would have been enough for Togo to go through, but they could not manage to get that draw. They lost 3-2 against Rwanda. The game was end-to-end. Togo will score, Rwanda will equalize. Togo scored, Rwanda equalized before eventually Rwanda had the final say in that game. All in all, it has been a great tournament. Last night we completed the group stages and we now know which teams will be participating in the quarterfinals, as you can see here on your screen. It is going to be great to see the teams in action. On Saturday, there will be games to look at. And on Saturday, Mali will take on Congo in the first game at 4 p.m. GMT. DR Congo will take on Cameroon in the ensuing game later in the evening, before on Sunday, 31st of January, Morocco will take on Zambia, and Zambia qualifying last night. Guinea also will take on Rwanda, who had that late winner, in which they helped them to overcome Togo in that game. A surprise for me was Tanzania, who I actually thought could make it to the next stage, but it wasn't to be for them in the end. They drew 2-2 last night against Guinea, and that was what made them lose their game. Namibia and Zambia played out a 0-0 draw, and Tanzania, who many of you wanted to qualify, I actually thought Tanzania would qualify, faltered, and that was how things ended for them in this competition. 8 teams left, 8 have gone home. They will compete for the crown to be named CHAN 2020 champions. My predictions for the quarterfinal stage: Mali versus Congo on Saturday. I think Mali will have enough in their locker to overcome Congo. As watching them throughout this tournament, they have grown from strength to strength, and beating Zimbabwe and also beating Burkina Faso and eventually drawing with Cameroon has brought them up to this stage. I see Mali going into semi-final of this competition. DR Congo versus Cameroon is going to be a really tricky fixture, but fans are allowed into this stadium, and I think DR Congo will give Cameroon a run for their money. The 12th man being the fans might give Cameroon that edge, but this will be tightly contested, and I think the hosts will come out of this unscathed. They will edge this one. Morocco versus Zambia. I think the Moroccans have grown now, and they have grown from strength to strength building up to this tournament. Many people were doubting, are these people who were the champions in 2018? Why are they not showing us? Well, they showed us in that final game, winning 5-2. So Morocco, I expect to beat Zambia and make it into the semis. Guinea versus Rwanda. Rwanda have had an amazing campaign so far. More or less, I feel they are the dark horses in this tournament, but against Guinea, they might come up short, and I expect Guinea to make it to the next round ahead of Rwanda. So those are the teams I expect to make it to the semi-final eventually, that will be played 2 days after the quarter-final. The tournament will wrap up on the 7th of February, and we'll be here to bring you updates on what happens throughout this tournament. Let me know your thoughts on the CHAN 2020 so far. Which team has been a standout team for you? Who do you think will win it now that we know our top 8 finalists? Let me know what you think in the comments box. I'll see you guys in the next one. CHAN tournament resumes on Saturday. Enjoy your day.